R24s like kings R23s. With great cards like those, there's no need to freeze. On Kerchak! And here's the host of Kerchak, Jim Perry.
Oh, happy 800 to you, too.
Yeah, this is our 800th show. Isn't that nice? Hello there. Welcome to Kerchak. Hello, Gene Wood.
Thanks to you, it's our 800th show.
And for the opening poem, yeah, this lady knows how the game is played. That eight is right up the middle, and a queen and four are equivalent, so a king and a three, Frida Feinberg of Seattle, Washington, watching on KING Channel 5. Thank you, Frida. Let's open the board and get to the cards and start number 800. Dennis Alois, we'll load them in. Here come our card charts. Patty Clark. Hi, Patty.
Hi, Jim. How are you?
I'm fine. And again, what should remind us about you?
Well, I'm from Walnut Creek. I work in Oakland running a computerized tomography unit, and I enjoy motorcycle riding and scuba diving.
Yeah, and you are a fast driver. You told me you whizzed down here from San Francisco,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, well, you get a little adrenaline going.
Yeah, 7-hour trip, you did it in 5 hours. It was worth it, though, because you won $2,000, so that's nice.
We're meeting our challenger for the first time, Ray Evanstad. Hello, Ray. Nice to meet you.
Ray Yancey Evanstad. I'm a senior citizen. I'm a native daughter of California. And I have a great adventure I'm going to do in December on my 69th birthday.
What's that?
I'm going to make my first parachute jump.
Oh, really? That is terrific. Why? What prompted you to decide to do that?
Well, for the first time, I live alone. I do my own gardening. I have a wonderful vegetable garden and animals. And first time in my life, I can do what I want to do. And also, yeah. I want to encourage young people and all people, you're only as old as you feel, so feel young.
Yeah. All right. Do you have an evangelist show on another network, Ray? Is that... Nice to have you here. That's a great attitude to have. You both cut the cards?
Sure it is.
Here we go. Let's start the best two games out of three with a question to Patty, the champion. Patty, we asked 100 psychiatrists. Generally speaking, is it natural for a mother to love her children more than she loves her husband? How many psychiatrists said, yes, it is natural for a mother to love her children more than her husband?
You know, it's a shame, too, because I like to see at least equal, but I think it's true. I think mothers do love their children more because it's part of them. I think that number's high, 80.
80 out of 100. Ray, higher or lower?
I agree fully, but I know that Mother Nature made the women to be the nest keepers mainly, and that's why we live longer than the men to take care of the nest, and I believe it's going to be a little higher than
Even
that.
Higher than that?
A little higher.
If it is higher, you'll play your cards, Ray. If not, Patty will play hers, and of course, if you can hit the answer right on the head at any time, it is a $500 bonus. The actual number of psychiatrists who said it is natural for a mother to love her children more than her husband is 64. Not higher, it's lower. Very high number, but not that high. So Patty gets the first crack of the cards where she's trying to work her way over to the end of the board to win the game. But if she can do it at any time in a five-card game with one play of the cards, that also is a $500 bonus. Patty, a queen.
Woo! Good start. Lower than that queen.
Lower than a queen. A six.
Higher than a six.
Risking it higher. No, four is not higher. She goes back to the base card, and Ray gets a free chance at a 10.
Change that card.
You did not win the question. You cannot change it. Nice try, Ray.
Okay, I'll say lower.
Lower than a 10. No, the king is not lower.
You misled me.
Fill in the space. Yeah, audience, why did you mislead her? Shame on you. Same two decks now. She's dealing the next cards off the top of those decks to fill in the spaces. And Ray, we have a question for you. We asked 100 men across the country. Have you ever woken up in the morning and discovered that you were not sleeping with the same woman you were dreaming about? How many men have done that?
Not being a man, but having lived a long, full life, and I've read a lot of things, I think that that would be about in the center, about 50.
50 out of 100 men were dreaming about somebody else.
I don't know. I think fantasies are a normal ordeal, and I think it's going to be higher.
Higher than that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. The key to this is fantasy. But the answer, let's find out. The actual number of men who've woken to discover they were not sleeping with the woman they were dreaming with is 51. By one, it is higher. Ray just missed the bonus, and she missed control of the cards. Patty with a queen.
Queen, let's go lower.
Lower than a queen. This time it is with a 9.
Let me freeze.
So, is she not going to try to run them? Taking a one-card advantage, that protects that position. And question three will be coming at you right after we take time out for this message of importance. We're in the middle of game one, and Patty with a nine needs three cards. Ray has a 10, needs four. And we're at question three. It goes to Patty. Patty, back in the 1930s, a lot of banks failed, so we asked 100 business economists, do you think that could ever happen again? How many economists do think there could be widespread bank failures again?
Boy, it's scary to think about, you know, with the way the economy's been going, the recession. I say that they'd have to feel that way. I'm going to say 72.
72 out of 100 business economists say it could happen again, Ray. What do you think?
I feel that when this happened in the past, the federal government stepped in for the future and fixed it so the banks won't do that because they have the Federal Reserve. But however, I feel it'll be a little lower.
So you say it's a little lower than that. The actual number of economists who think there could be widespread bank failures again is 37. You're right, Ray. It is much lower. Yeah, they have done some protection against it. And Ray, you've got a 10.
Change that card.
Now you can change that card. And the 10 becomes an... Oh, not a good change, an 8.
I'm going to say lower.
Ah, because the audience was shouting higher. Right,
time.
So she's going against you, audience. She says lower. And no, she should have gone with them.
Woo!
And Patty with a free chance.
I got queen nine. Let's go lower.
Lower than a nine. No, king is not lower. Now as we fill in the spaces, look at that board. Patty near the middle with a nine needs three cards. Ray smack up the middle with an eight needs four. Sudden death. Someone's going to have to win it right here, and it looks like control of this question could decide it. Ray, we asked 100 single women who support the women's liberation movement. Have you ever asked a man out for a date? How many feminists said they have asked a man out for a date?
Oh, that's going to be high because this is what they're all about. They're coming from that area. So they would definitely, I would say that's high number. Oh, 78.
78 out of 100. I get the feeling you would have been a feminist in your day, Ray. I think so. 78? What do you think, Patty?
Boy, that's tough. I agree with her wholly. I'm going to go a little higher.
A little higher than that. Looks like she put you on the spot with the number, though, for a moment.
She did.
Decides control and sudden death, 78 and higher. The actual number of feminists who've asked a man out for a date is 70. Not higher, it's lower. Ray gets control. A lot of them, but not that high. Now, Ray, it is sudden death. You could play it. Of course, you could change that base card if you'd like. You need four cards. Patty needs a nine with three. Play it or pass it?
I'll pass it.
You're going to pass it. Patty, you've got a nine. You must play it, and you must get all three to win. If not, the game belongs to Ray.
Lower than that.
Lower,
nine.
She says. It is a six.
Woo! Higher than a six.
Higher than a six? No, a three is not, and Ray wins game one in sudden death. So it's game one to the challenger. And we will clear the board and set up for game two. And Ray has her first $100. Congratulations for that. Same two decks of cards. Next card's off the top of the deck.
That's gonna
and now
pay
the pressure.
For my, lessons for my parachute jump.
Oh, you haven't taken the lessons yet?
Oh, no. You do it the same day. You get 4 hours of lessons in the morning, and then you do it.
And it costs, hope you get a good teacher, Ray.
And it costs $85.
Right. And with the other $15, buy a cushion, all right? Starting game two. Patty. We asked 100 people, if President Reagan, oh, listen to this, 100 people. If President Reagan called you at home, collect, would you accept the charges? How many people would accept a collect call from the president?
I mean, just to say, no matter who it is, just to say you got a call from the president would be pretty hot on the block. I think it's going to be somewhere around 78.
78 out of 100 would accept the collect call from the president, Ray.
But I believe that we should have it higher than that because anyone would for that
trip. I would love to, just regardless if it was Mr. Reagan or anybody else, I'd love to just so he could say, don't bother me while I'm eating. You know, 78 and higher. The actual number of people who would accept the collect call from the president is 59. Not higher, it's lower. Just a little more than half would accept the call from the president. Patty, you start off this game with a 10.
Change that card.
Changing the 10 to an 8.
Woo!
Change.
Let's go lower than that.
Lower than the 8, a 4.
Higher than the
4. Risky and higher, a 6.
Green.
Not going to take a chance.
Green.
She wants the 2-card advantage.
Green,
she needs
one.
This game. Ray, we asked 100 women nudists at a nudist camp in California. Have you ever parachuted in the... No, that was not the question. I'm sorry.
It gets scratched.
You are well padded. 100 women nudists at a nudist park in California. While at a nudist park, have you ever imagined what a man looked like with his clothes on? How many women have said they've tried to imagine what a man would look like with his clothes on?
I don't think they'd even think about that, because they probably are out there with one of their boyfriends or their husbands or the neighbor's friend, and they know what they look like when they have their clothes on. So I'm going to say that's going to be relatively low, that they would even think that. I'd say about 17.
17 out of 100 would imagine what he would look like with his clothes on.
Well, why ruin a good thing? But I think your imagination runs as wild as it's going to go. It's got to be a little higher.
Yeah. If you've seen them without, maybe the clothes on is a turn on. Kind of a switch. Let's find out. A fun question. 17 and higher. The actual number of women nudists who imagine what a nude man would look like with his clothes on is 48. It's higher. Yeah. Patty, you've got a 6.
Same deck card.
And winning the question, of course, she can change it at a 10.
Lower than the 10.
Lower than a 10. A 7.
3.
And again, Patty is being very conservative. And will her conservatism pay off? We'll find out right after this. See, we were talking about socks. Gene Wood, get over here. Now, wait a minute. Catch up my socks. Regular black socks, right? Get up here. Quickly now. Come on. We haven't done... I did this once before. Knocking my socks. Would you quickly show me your sock? No nonsense, quickly. Knocking my sock. See, get out of here. Enough of you with socks. Game one went to the challenger. We do have some fun here in the studio. Come down and join us sometime, won't you? And now in game two, Patty needs one card to tie up the match, and the question goes to Patty. Patty, we surveyed 100 men who are top business executives, and we asked them, has your success also brought you happiness? How many business executives said yes, success has brought them happiness?
Well, it wouldn't necessarily be the only factor, but you can't get too unhappy with a lot of good money. I'd say about 63.
63 out of 100 say, yeah, their success has brought them happiness. Ray, higher or lower?
Well, it maybe brought them ulcers, wouldn't be too happy, but then they're pretty proud to show the boys they did all right and make their wife very happy that they were successful. So,
63, she
so
says.
So she has 63.
Yeah.
I'll go a little higher.
A little higher. Gotta put you on the spot there. You were hesitating with that one. The actual number of business executives who said success has brought them happiness is 86. You're right. It is higher. Ray, you got a lot of catching up to do in this game, and you start with a jack.
Trade jack card.
Gonna try to improve it. Oh, the audience doesn't like that decision. For good cause. You've got an 8.
Lower.
Lower than the 8. No, queen is not lower. And now we'll see if the freeze pays off, because Patty gets a free cat chance.
Higher, she said.
Had a lot of trouble getting it out, but Patty I didn't want to give you the free chance. I couldn't say that. We've got a tie. Each player, one game, $100. We set up for the tiebreaker. 3 cards up there, 3 questions here. Would you stop laughing because I made a spoonerism and she's going to make fun of me? All right. Starting the tiebreaker with Ray. Ray, we asked 100 married women, if you had a one-night fling with another man, would you keep it a secret from your husband? How many women said if they had a one-night fling with another man, they would keep it from their husband?
This is a very interesting question, because I'm sure that happens a lot more than we realize or we think about. So I think that a wife that wants to stay married with her husband, she sure isn't going to give it away.
How many would keep it from him?
The ones that would keep it from him would be a high number. So I would say 72.
72 out of 100, Patty.
Yeah, but how many are going to admit it? I think it's a little lower.
A little lower than that. I don't know. Oh, the audience got a little buzz. No, kind of a toughie on this one. Let's see. 72 and lower. The actual number of married women who said if they had a one-night fling with another man, they would keep it from their husband is 66. It's lower. One out of 3 would tell him. Isn't that interesting? Woo! Patty in the tiebreaker with a 5.
Change the card, please.
And the 5 becomes an ace.
Woo! Lower than the ace.
Lower than the ace, a 3.
Higher than that 3.
For the championship.
Yes! Patty wins it big. Ace, three, king. Well, the champion makes a comeback and wins two in a row. Ray, we have to say goodbye. Oh, don't go away yet. Love, I want to say... I'm going to go over here and say goodbye. Ray, you're leaving me. Ray, can you come over here? I wanted to say goodbye, Ray. No, I didn't. Goodbye. You got $100 and some party gifts. Okay, bye. I'm going to stay here in the dark, and we'll be back after this commercial. We're going to play the light bill. Back with our champion, Patty Clark. Patty, you made a great comeback there, getting two in a row.
Hey, it was hot. She's a fun player.
You got the money, Clark?
I sure have.
Let's get up there and play them right now. Let's wish Patty well. Come on, girl. Here we go. Patty, we're going to give you $200, again, of new money, as we give you three cards on the bottom line and your decision how you bet them. So I slow down. Excuse me, Janice. Oh, you got them all right in time. I see. Another $200. You and Gene Wood just keep padding your part through the years, don't you, there? We had another $200. Big bet. You must risk at least half. You all set?
I'm ready.
Now, here you're on your own. You don't lose with a double. One thing we have done through the years, I must say, has made it easier for people to win money, and that's one of the ways. You don't lose on a double. Here's $200. And, of course, you can change your base card. Thank you, Lois. We'll start Patty off with 200 and a 10.
Change that card.
I think she means it. Can she improve it? Oh. Well, you're starting badly with the 8.
A little $50 higher.
Higher than the 8 for $50. And right with a 9.
I'm going to say a little $50 higher.
Again, but this time a little against the odds. Higher. Yes? Cards haven't been too good, but you're calling them right.
I'm gonna bet 150 lower.
Half of it on a 10, $150.
Twice.
I hope you're right. Lower. No. Look at that. 8, 9, 10, Jack.
It did.
You were so conservative for a while, then you got a little carried away. All right, come on. Let's get your wits about you as we move up the Jack and give you another 200.
All right.
Do you want the Jack?
200 lower.
You're going to play the Jack on this level?
Yeah.
And she says lower for 200. She's right. Okay. With a 5.
I'm going to say 300 higher.
300 on the 5. Higher. Yes, with a 9. Again, near the middle. Now, watch
it. I'm going to say $50 lower.
$50. Oh, let's see one really low. You've had bad cards. Let's see a good one right now. Lower. It's lower, but it is the worst card. However, you don't have to play it.
Change that card.
You sure Lewis. Deserve a good one with this one, Patty. And for the big bet, you'll play. And it's all right.
All of it lower.
$1,800. If this is lower. No. However, that rule about the double just saved you $900 because you have $900 with that. Wow! You could not get on track with those money cards to save your life. But with the other $900, $3,100 for Patty Davis. That's really good. We'll be back with a new challenger after this. Double eight. All righty, Patty Clark, good luck as we start a new match. Two brand new decks of cards and a new challenger on Card Sharks. Hello there. We are running out of time, so if you just tell us your name and where you're from, sir.
I'm Cal Davis, originally from Chicago, Illinois. I live in Anaheim.
Well, happy to have you here. I know you want to get into the match. You cut the cards?
Yes, I have.
And here we go, starting the best 2 out of 3 with the question to Patty. Patty, we asked 100 married men. Very simply, should a married man wear a wedding ring? How many married men said yes? A married man should wear a wedding ring.
I've heard an awful lot of excuses, like I could have my finger ripped off on the job, or I think
how many
it's
say
good
they
right
should?
In the middle. 52.
52 out of 100 married men say they should.
I agree with her reasoning, but I'm going to have to say I was married myself, and I couldn't stand it. I had a lot of excuses, but I think that number's got to be lower.
Lower than that. The actual number of men who said a married man should wear a wedding ring is 71, not lower, it is higher. Cal didn't like it, but Patty got it, and she starts with a 5.
Change that card.
And the 5 becomes a 3.
Woo! Higher than a 3.
Higher than a 3. A 10.
Lower than a 10.
Risky and lower. No one king is not lower. Patty, that means Cal gets a free chance to play a 2.
Good card. Higher.
Higher than a 2. An 8.
Hey, lower.
Lower than the ace. A 10.
Lower.
He's going to try the gamble. He's right with a 7.
Higher. That's
trying to go all for a run in the game, and yes! Cal did it! The game at a 500 out of the list. What a start for the challenger. That's all the time we have. We have people today from St. Louis, Missouri, at Chapel Hill, North Carolina. We'll finish this match in the next card shot. Bye-bye.
This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.